please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Let's discuss some stocks now. Sanjiv Bhasin of IIFL joins in. Sanjiv, hi, good morning. The reappointment of Rana Kapoor, at least the tenure, is hanging in the air. We don't know for how long it could be, but we know that he is in for now. You think this is enough to lap up on the stock, or do you think this uncertainty hanging could sort of, you know, keep a lid on the gains in the near term?
Yeah, morning. So Sonia, you know, some of the large caps have given 2-3 times opportunities for extraneous reasons where they've corrected. I'll just take a minute. You know, first it was Ashok Leyland on the back of the Axle norm change, it came down to 105. Then it was Hindalco on the buyout of Valerius, it came to 195. And both those were opportunities. And I again think that 360 for us would be an opportunity in Yes Bank. It has been one of the outperformers in the banking, paradigm. And we still think that maybe one leg would be missing if Mr. Rana Kapoor changes. But we think the bank has grown in stature and size, and they will be able leaders to make it through. His being there will be an icing on the cake, and I think there will be a bout of short covering and value buying. But we think that Yes Bank is at the forefront of one of the best amalgamations between retail and corporate loans, and it will keep its image going for the near to medium term.
See, I know all of you are extremely impressed by the manner in which Yes Bank has multiplied shareholders' money. Mm. But we must know, what is a banking institution? The shareholders' money is only 10%. Capital adequacy, maybe 16%. The rest of it is depositors' money. And if rules are being broken, it's a serious offense.
It's a crime.
I mean, okay, market, people made money and all that, fine. But let us put it on the table that banks are special. They are not, a Tata Steel or any steel company is all its own money. Here it is, 90% or maybe 85%. Other people's money, common people's money. It is a special institution. So while the stock market still may cheer for other reasons, a divergence is an important issue that, we shouldn't take it lightly. I just got a little emotional on the point.
No, that point is taken. I mean, there are two different issues we're talking about, right?
Yes.
One is the market reaction and the other is
the moral issue.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But anyways, let's move on from this then. Sanjiv, good morning. I wanted your thoughts on power stocks. After a long time, we have seen move in names like NTPC, Power Grid. Your thoughts on whether this is a sustainable move?
Yeah, so Anuj, we've been contrarian, and it is starting to play out. Firstly, on three large caps, where we had to go through a lot of pain of underperformance, but ITC, Sun, and Ultratech have outperformed, and I think now they're going to lead the Nifty higher. Similar is our view on power stock. We think, you named it Power Grid, NTPC. Now, those are the large cap, but they'll be sluggish movers. However, the real action is in names like Adani, CG Power, and the power financiers itself. We've heard the conversations, we've met the management of REC, PFC, and they are very, very positive. They are saying that the road ahead is very, very clear. This, hiatus on the power producer and Allahabad Bank is going to get sorted. And anyway, they have already taken enough provision. So PFC, REC, aside from the 8% dividend yield, look also set for much more better performance on the asset quality and rise in net interest incomes going forward. So they are little high beta, high risk strategies, but I think power will be the dark horse of 2019 as a sector.
Okay.